I was fascinated by the number of remarkable instruments that people play and how they play them. And I just thought of this project as something like growing music, because that's what we do all around the world.
I came in with that same kind of passion in the idea of creating music that would connect to science and culture and all basically the curriculum. And we've also worked on this idea of creativity in education. How do you bring that back? So we started by sourcing the bamboo locally, so going to garden centres.
You get a piece of bamboo
and we measured it to the correct size.
And then we had to cut them all at the first line of the nodule
so that you'd get the
this bit.
Then we had to sand it so it wouldn't hurt our lips when we blow into it.
So then Maurizio taught us how to do a 3-knot.
And then I think somebody would test out.
And then we tuned them.
Sometimes you might need it a bit higher than it actually is, so you put more plasticine in to get the right note.
This is the first phase of growing music, and we've been really lucky to come and work with Shaw School and with Carol Sampi, who won an award for her science teaching this year.
They get a huge amount, actually. They don't realise when they're learning because there's so many different aspects to it, and actually there's an awful lot on paper to try and teach the children, but it came quite naturally because they could see all of the links between the various things that we were looking at, and their questions also led on to other things that we wanted to find out about.
Because Maurizio's Colombian, we've been learning about Colombia, and so I really enjoyed that. We got to do lots of research and it was really fun.
For me, the important thing too, apart from the science and music, is all the other cross-curricular elements in the project.
To have these memorable experiences for children is really important. The children have been engaged with what's been going on right from the very beginning, planting the bamboo, making the pan pipes, and today performing to their parents.
There's a real kind of way of integrating education. So they not only get to learn about facts and how plants grow, so from the biology onto the materials, the properties of the materials, the uses of these materials, bamboo being and such an amazing material to learn about.
Our teacher let's go away and find at least 101 things that could be made out of bamboo, and some of them were quite surprising because you could find things out like parts of cars and scaffolding.
As part of our science, we do measure and water the bamboo.
And I learned that bamboo is a sort of grass and it can grow up to really, really high.
We've also learned about vibration in science. So we've learned that, for example, when you blow up against the top of each bamboo pipe, the air inside it vibrates, it isn't the pipe.
I really enjoyed everything because you get to learn new things, and bamboo for me was just a plant that pandas ate. I didn't really know that it could be used for so many things.
I've enjoyed making the pan pipes because it was something new, making a new instrument, and it was quite hard sometimes, but that was something enjoyable.
Being with your friends and making things with them, and you get to play music and you get to do loads of fun things, so.
I think one of the loveliest things in the project for me was actually this afternoon watching 50 children come together to play, each with their own instrument, but playing harmonies, melodies together that 5 days ago they couldn't.
And what is amazing is that they begin to play the instrument way before they actually know how it's played or anything, so that is actually very exciting to see. Oh, okay, they got it.